following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
I'm glad you came to see us again, and we're going to have a good time like we usually do. But first, you better let me go put my groceries away. What have we got over here? Oh, looks like somebody's going into business. Here's a nice sign that says, Lemonade for Sale. Isn't this a cute stand? I wonder who built it. Very nice. Rufus! Hi, Rufus. I haven't seen you in a while. Oh. You remember Rufus? Oh. He only lives a couple blocks from here. And he's come over to start a business on Sesame Street? Is this your stand, Rufus? Well, very good. I wish you lots of luck in your business venture. Listen, Rufus, how much does your lemonade cost? I see the sign, Lemonade for Sale. But how much are you charging? You know what I mean. How much does it cost a glass? If I wanted a glass, how much would I have to pay you? Get it? How much does it cost? Oh, 5 cents? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? More? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, 10 cents. Well, you know, that's a good price, yeah. Rufus, you know what, though? I think you really should have a sign that says 10 cents so everybody knows right away, you know, how much it's going to cost. You have anything to make a sign on? Oh, you have some cardboard. Do you have anything to write with? A pen? Good. Now, can I help you with it or anything? You know how to write 10 cents? You know what 10 looks like? Oh, good. Okay. 10 cents. Rufus, are you sure you know what the number 10 looks like? Oh, you do? Oh, good. Okay. I'll hold the sign for you. Go ahead, write. Rufus. 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 Rufus, wait a minute. I'm not sure what that is, but I know what it's not. That's not the number 10, Rufus. No, dear. I think you need a little lesson in numbers. Well, Rufus, I see you learned how to make the number 10. Now you have your signs. Lemonade for sale, 10 cents. Very good. You're all ready to go into business? You have all your things out and everything? What's the matter? What's the matter? You look a little puzzled. Did you forget something? I don't think so. Look, mm-hmm. you have your pitcher of lemonade, right? Mm-hmm. You have your glasses. Mm-hmm. You have your napkins in case you spill anything. Mm-hmm. What else do you need to open a lemonade stand?
Mm-hmm. Hey, Susan.
Hi, honey.
Oh, Rufus, what do you have here?
Rufus just opened up a lemonade stand.
Oh, yeah?
Would you like to be his first customer?
Well, wouldn't I? Let me see. 10 cents for a glass of lemonade. I think I can swing 10 cents out here for this. I'll have a glass. I'll have a glass.
Well, he thinks he's forgotten something, you know, and he's looking for it.
Well, I'll tell you one thing he's forgotten. He's forgotten me because I'm a customer and I want some lemonade. Lemonade, lemonade.
Ooh,
yeah,
ooh,
right, yeah.
You're about to lose your customer, Rufus.
Oh, there you go. Ooh. Look at that. Well, okay, here's a glass of lemonade. I've got that. Now, here's your 10 cents.
Ooh.
1 penny,
mm-hmm.
2,
mm-hmm.
3,
mm-hmm.
4, 5, mm-hmm. 6, 7, 8,
mm-hmm.
9,
mm-hmm.
10. There you are, 10 pennies. Next 10 cents there. Okay, now, while I'm drinking my lemonade, maybe you can try to remember whatever it was you forgot. Mm. This is just water. Yeah. You forgot the lemons. You forgot the lemons.
Oh,
oh
Rufus,
man.
Is that what you forgot? The lemons for your lemonade? Oh, Rufus.
Oh, well, look, I'll tell you what, Rufus. We're old friends and all that, but I can't pay you 10 cents just for a glass of water. Yeah. Oh. Well, no. Keep the pennies. I'll tell you what you do. Go down to Mr. Hooper's store, okay? Mm-hmm. Buy some lemons, and I'll come back later on for a glass of real lemonade, Rufus style. See you later.
Well, you can't make lemonade without lemons any more than you could make tomato juice without real tomatoes like these.
Rufus, you have my lemonade ready now? No, you do, huh? Oh, look, the lemons.
Here,
you got
I'll
the
help
lemons.
You.
Good. Oh, you can tell that you've got all the ingredients now. I see the
That's
lemons
enough.
Right there. Oh,
there
here it is.
You go.
Thank you, my man. It was a pleasure doing business with you. Certainly was. See you later.
That's good, Rufus. You know, this was a learning experience. You learned how to make lemonade. You found out that all you needed was some water, some lemons, and some sugar. What's the matter, Rufus? I said, you learned how to make lemonade. You found out that all you needed was some water, some lemon, and some sugar. Rufus? Oh, Rufus, you didn't forget the sugar, did you? But Gordon just took... Honey, don't drink that lemonade because Rufus... Rufus, I think Gordon drank the lemonade. You didn't put any sugar in it at all, did you? Mm. Don't you know that you have to put at least a spoonful of sugar in every glass?
Mm. By George, Rufus, that is delicious lemonade. Best I've ever had. Gordon told me you had a little trouble, getting exactly right with the right amount of lemon and just the right amount of sugar, but... That's really terrific. It's delicious.
Hey, what's going on out here? What's all the noise?
We're not making any noise, Oscar. Just having a little lemonade. Hey, by the way, have you two met Rufus? This is Oscar. Oscar, this is Rufus. Oh. Rufus, come up from back there. Rufus, come up. Have you met Oscar?
He looks like a moving dust mop.
Yeah, come on, Oscar. Oscar, that's not very, very nice. He's just a nice, big, white, shaggy dog. And Rufus, Oscar is just an old grouch.
Of course I'm a grouch. I've got a right to grouch. What would you do if somebody built a dumb lemonade stand practically in your front yard?
What would I do? I'd probably go out and buy a nice glass of lemonade. That's what I'd do.
Fat chance.
Hey, Rufus, I got an idea. Why don't you give Oscar just a little lemonade, let him try it out, see if he likes it, okay? Just give him some in a glass. Come on, it's a good idea. If he tries it, he'll like it. Pour him up a little lemonade, okay? Just put some in the glass right here. Okay, that ought to do it.
Huh. Boy, are you stingy. That's not much of a taste.
You know, he's right, Rufus.
Mm-hmm.
I think you'd better add some more lemonade. Give him a better taste. Just put a little more lemonade in. I said just put a little more. Add some more lemonade. You do understand about some and more, don't you, Rufus? You understand about some and more? You don't understand about some and more.
What a weird dog you got there, Bob. What a weird, stupid dog.
Oscar, do you understand about some and more?
Of course not. But I like it that way.
That figures. Hey, let me try and straighten you out on this. Okay, Rufus? Now, we have a little bit of lemonade in this glass, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have some in there. Now, if I take this glass and I put, about that much, we have more lemonade in this glass, right? A little in here and more in here. Now in the third glass, watch carefully, watch. Don't take your eyes off this for a minute. If I fill that right up to the top, we have now the most lemonade in here, right? We have a little in here, we have more in here, and we have the most in that glass. Got that straight? You sure? You're positive. Okay, I'm gonna check you on it. Now, what I want you to do is to hide your eyes. Hide your eyes. Like this. Put your hand like this. Yeah, that's it. Come on. Keep it over. Hide your eyes. Okay, come on. Hide your eyes now. Keep your eyes. That's it. Okay, now I'm gonna mix up these glasses. I'm gonna put the more here and the most here and the some. No fair peeking. Come on. Keep it down. I'm going to put the sum here and the most here and the more here and then the sum over here. And let's see. Well, okay, I think that's pretty good. Now you can take your paw off your eyes now and you can take it off now. Come on. You can look now. That's it. Okay. Now, take a hi. Okay. Now, take a close look. Which glass has the least amount of lemonade in it? Look carefully. You got to look. I don't think you can smell it. This one? Very, very good. That's terrific. This glass has the least amount of lemonade. Now, which glass has a little more lemonade in it? Which glass has a little more in it? Not the most, but a little more. This one? Terrific. You're very, very... Gee, you're a smart dog, Rufus. Okay, now, which glass has the most lemonade in it? That's a hard one? Well, think hard. Come on, you can do it. This one here. You're absolutely right, Rufus. That's terrific. You're the smartest dog I've ever known. Okay, now this glass has just a little, this has more, and this has the most, right? Okay, now let's see which one Oscar wants. Oscar, would you like to have a glass with just a little lemonade in it? Or would you like to have a glass with a little more? Or would you like the glass with the most lemonade in it? Which one would you like?
You left one out.
What's that?
None. I want no lemonade. I want no lemonade stand in my front yard. I want nobody bothering me. And what I really want is a soundproof trash can.
Oh, Oscar. That Oscar, he has some terrible temper. Did you know that? He really does. By the way, did you know that terrible and temper are both T words. Watch. Terrible. Ooh. And temper.
Ooh. Hello, Rufus. How are you doing, huh? Mm. What's the matter? Nobody's buying any lemonade? Mm. Oh, well, listen, Rufus. What you ought to do is use a little more salesmanship. Oh, yeah, you got to go like that and really sock it to him. Yeah, sure. Look, have you thought about that? Trying a little salesmanship? Huh? Oh, your free gift with each glass. Good idea. Good idea, Rufus. What are you giving away? A dog biscuit? Giving away a dog biscuit? Well, I don't know that many people who, you know, like dog biscuits with their lemonade. That's kind of weird or something. Well, dog biscuit. Well, I'll tell you what, Rufus. I'll buy a glass of lemonade. I'll have another glass. Yeah, I'll have another glass of lemonade. No? Why? It's all gone? All that? Oh, Rufus, how many glasses did you sell, huh? Huh? How many glasses of one? One glass of lemonade? Oh, but well, where did all the lemonade go? Where did all the rest of it go? It's a big pitcher. Where did all the rest of the lemonade? You drank it? You drank all the rest of the lemonade? Oh, Rufus. Oh. You drank all... Well, at least you sold one glass and you made some money, right? Oh, sure. Yeah, let's count this money, see how much you made. You got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. That's 10 pennies, Rufus. That's a lot of money. Oh, Rufus, do you know what you can buy with 10 pennies? Huh? Oh, listen, you can buy 10 pieces of bubble gum. Oh, man. And you can buy 10 pieces of 1-penny candy. Oh, you can get a newspaper for 10 cents. Oh, you can buy... Rufus, you're practically rich.
Hiya, Rufus. Oh. Hello. How's the lemonade business?
Oh, Mr. Hooper, Rufus made 10 cents selling lemonade.
10 cents?
Yeah, isn't that great?
It certainly is.
Sure. How about that?
I should say it is, yeah. Because it so happens, Rufus, that you owe me 10 cents for lemons you bought at my store to make lemonade with. One, two, three, four... Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Well, I tell you, it looks like poor old Rufus didn't make a thin dime off of all that lemonade. You know, didn't make any money at all. But from the news I hear up and down Sesame Street, I hear that Rufus is going into a new kind of business. Yeah, new kind of business. Now, let's go down here and see what it's all about. Come on. Uh-huh. Says, neat stuff for sale. 10 cents a piece. Well, let's check it out. You see, oh, hi, Rufus. Oh, come on, Rufus. You really expect to sell this kind of stuff? Yeah, but it won't work. No, it won't work, Rufus. You can't sell. It's all junk. Sure. Yeah. You don't think so? Oh, well... I don't mean to hurt your feelings or anything, man, but this is all kind of... Oh, you dig that. Okay, but I mean, it's all junky stuff, Rufus. Look at it. For example, what are you going to do with this? What kind of thing is this? Oh, it's a thing. You're going to sell this. What do you do with it? What do you do? Go ahead. What do you do? Is that all? And you dig that? That gets to you. Oh, come on, come on, Rufus. What do you do with... You mean you just... Rufus, nobody's gonna pay 10 cents so they can go bang, 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 or a thing like... No, okay, forget it, Rufus, forget it. Cool it, Rufus, easy. Wait a minute. Forget about that. What about this? This, you know what this is? A beat-up, broken brick. That's all it is. Nothing more than a beat up broken. No? More? All right, what do you do with it?
I'm here. What?
Oh, come on, Rufus. You mean somebody's gonna buy that just because you pick it up and go like, clunk? That's a clunk thing. No, Rufus, no, but look, Rufus, I hate to tell you this, but it won't work. It just won't work. Hey. There's no way in the world I could.
What's going on over here?
Hi, Oscar. How are you? Rufus has got this rotten, mangy, rancid, no good, corrugated, rusted, stupid pile of junk here. Yeah, and he's trying to sell it. You know, who could he sell that stuff to? That doesn't make any sense.
Well, I'll buy it.
You will?
Sure. That's one of the finest collections of junk I've ever seen. It would look beautiful on my mantelpiece. I tell you what, I'll give you $1 for the whole pile. How about that? Is that a deal? Listen, you do that one more time, you mangy dust mop, and the deal is off.
Boy, that Oscar and Rufus, aren't they funny? Oh, that's some combination. Hey, why don't you turn around here, Carl and Gillian, and let's hear the story today called Look at Me. I have one round head that can turn, that can shake, that I lift from my pillow when I awake. I have one small nose that can smell, breathe, or sneeze, and gets red when I freeze. I have one wide mouth so my voice can come out, arf, says the dog, to sing you a song, to whisper, or shout. Here is one wet tongue to taste what I eat, spicy or salty, sour or sweet. I have one straight back, like a trunk of a tree. It's hard to reach. You scrub it for me. And one pumping heart I cannot see, but it's there, thump, 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 inside of me. You ever feel your heartbeat? Sure. And covering me is a waterproof skin. It's tough. You can pinch it. But look, it's quite thin. Did you ever think your skin was waterproof? The water doesn't leak inside. See my two moving eyebrows? And underneath those, two eyes with lids I can open and close. With two open ears on the sides of my head, I can listen to music and hear what is said. Happy birthday, have some cake. How do you do? What's your name? Turn down the TV. Quiet. Blah, 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 blah. Ho, ho, hee, 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 ha, ha. My two arms have muscles. And here are my hands for holding or clapping or doing handstands. My two knobby knees feel hard as stones. My two long legs have long, strong bones. I have two busy feet that can jump, that can run, hold me down on the ground, help me climb, and that's fun. I have five wiggling toes, and four look quite small, but the big toe is biggest and strongest of all. And here are five fingers, for work or for play, to push with, to touch, hide my face, point that way. I can count the nails on my fingers and toes. I can count my teeth in two even rows. And also my hair, but that's hard to do. There are so many hairs that I'd never get through. I am up, I am down, turning left, turning right. Here I am. Look at me. Good morning. Good night. Did you like that story? It was all in rhyme. That was fun, looking at all the different parts of the body. You like that story, Gillian?
Yes.
You liked it, Carl?
Yes.
Good.
Come on, Carl.
Bye. Boy, those kids, they'll sit still to listen to a book for at least a minute or two, and then zing. Back to the jump rope. I think that Rufus took his lemonade stand down. I certainly hope he made some money, though. Oh. Rufus, I thought you went home. What are you still doing here? You were waiting for me? Oh, you must be hungry. Do you want some milk or something? No? You're still here. Well, why don't you go home? You know, Gail will be looking for you. What's this? For me? What is it? A present? May I open it now? I can? Oh, did you wrap it yourself and everything? Oh, Rufus, that's nice. Do you mean that all the work over at the lemonade stand you were doing was so that you could get me a present? Oh, Rufus, that's very nice. I can't wait to see what it is. It's a doggy bone. I've never had a doggy bone before. You see, people don't usually have doggy bones. Usually just dogs have doggy bones. I mean, you know, people aren't usually lucky enough to have anybody give them a doggy bone for a gift. And since you gave it to me, Rufus, well, gee, I think it's really one of the nicest presents I've ever had in my life. Gee, that's nice. Thank you. It's a beautiful present. A beautiful present. All polished up friendly, with shiny thoughts decorating it. A beautiful present, with bows of bright wishes, and little tin bells on the top, singing such a pretty ditty. It's a beautiful present, with joy on the inside, and loving that money can buy anywhere. It was nice of you to think of me. It's a beautiful present. A beautiful present, and I'm much too happy for this little tear in my eye. Thank you very much.
Okay, so what we're going to do here, Joe, you listening? We're going to learn about whole rhythm of things. See what this. Hey, Mr. Hooper.
Yes, Gordon.
Before you throw those two tin cans out, we're talking about rhythm.
You know what?
Like, oh yeah, like beats, rhythm. You know the whole thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And what we could use, I think, to help us explain it is tin cans.
What? Yeah, be my guest.
Because I tell you what we're gonna do, Jill. It's one for you. Carl, a big one. Clay, and all right. That one's for you, Gillian. And Mr. Hooper, if you don't mind, have a seat and join our band.
Thank you.
Because we're going to have a rhythm band going here. Now, let's show you a couple kinds of rhythm, okay? Here's one kind. Can you play that kind? Come on, everybody try to play it. Cease, halt, doing very well, okay? We'll try another kind, but this time I want everybody to do something just a little bit different, but make sure it's the same kind of rhythm, okay? So, Carl, you're gonna have to start off. Now, we're gonna have to go very easily so we make sure it's right, okay? And you're gonna hold down the whole fort, right? You got it? Can you do it? You sure? Okay, here we go. Okay, now stop just for a second. Now, remember there were four beats. One, two, three, four, right? Now, when you start that, then Gillian, are you repairing your drum? Huh? Okay. Then when he starts that, then you want to come in on beat number one and beat number three, right? so that when Carl's going one, two, three, four, then you hit your drum on one and three, right? You follow me? Okay, let's just try that part. Come on, Carl, let's go. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Come on, baby. Three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay, fine. Stop, stop. Okay, once more with you, Jill, and you take beat number two and number four, okay? Okay, here we go. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay. Beat number two and number four, Mr. Hooper, if you come on in. A little syncopation. Good. See, not bad.
Okay, men, ready to count off? One, two, three, four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten. Okay, men, fall out.
Well, it was the day when Rufus came to Sesame Street, a day of lemonade, day of junk and tin cans, a day to remember, right? Right. Okay, this was a day to remember, and you remember to come back here on Sesame Street, where we'll be, and you come back and join us, okay? Okay.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today with the letters A, H, and T, and by the number 10. Look at Me was written by Marguerita Rudolph, pictures by Karla Kuskin, published by McGraw-Hill, copyright 1967. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.